Again, you continue to amaze me when you're. I'm hoping we still get this. I would still pick it up. The lazy llama beans. I'm gonna surprise James and get this.
I was thinking the same thing. Bobby's not gonna think I'm gonna get an Earth Spark figure. It just looked like it looked dated.
Yes. Yeah, I like details too. Like the around the belt buckle area. His bended elbow wouldn't bend like this. It would bend like this.
Yeah.
The red and the yellow still looks like it's prototype material. Hey, welcome back, Bot vs. Con fans. As always, I'm your guy, Bobby the Bot.
And I'm James the Con.
And we're back with another round of news for the beginning of the week. But before we jump into that, let's give a special shout out to our official sponsor, The Chosen Prime, where, of course, you can find many of the figures we'll talk about, either now, pre-order, or eventually. Also, where you can find any of your other hobby collecting toys. And with that, we also want to give a shout out to our members. Really appreciate you helping support the channel, keeping us along this journey, and to our subscribers. Again, without you, there will be no us. So with that, let's go ahead and jump into the news.
Yes, so we have a lot to go over, so if we're brief, excuse us. But the first thing is, so TF Nation is having a mini con in Reading for one day because I guess their main con sold out like so fast. So there's a little bit south and they're having it only for one day, which I think is pretty cool.
Yeah, that's really cool. Especially for those who are missing out. So I like that.
Yeah, exactly. Well, let's get into some leaks, and there's quite a few. The first one is Generation Select Smallfoot. What do you think about this?
This is a James special right here. I saw this and I thought it was like a custom or something like that. I do like the gears. I'm not familiar with this character. I think it's kind of cool how they did the ponytails on her, but I think that is still a little bit too human.
I don't think that's ponytails. I just think that's the backpack.
The two pink parts?
Is that what that's supposed to be?
Yeah.
Oh, I just see it as gears, but in pink.
Yeah.
Gears has the same thing, it's just silver.
Yeah, so I've seen some art.
Now I'm not going to be able to see Gears without silver ponytails from here on out.
Yeah, I saw some pictures of her and like art form, and yeah, she's supposed to have two like pigtails, so I was like, okay, that's a little too much too human for me, but the colors definitely clash. But I'm interested to see what else comes in this three-pack.
Yeah, well, we already know Treads.
Treads.
The last one's going to be Pathfinder, I believe was leaked, which is a blue Cosmos. And I forgot to say, these pictures are via Reddit user Cillipod, and then a bunch of numbers. There's the G1 version. I hate this.
Oh.
I think this is and it's the pink face. If the face was silver, like Gears is, I'd probably like it, but I hate the pink, the colors clash too much, and this figure is going to make me not pick up this set.
Wow.
It won't be worth it. This is, it's pretty accurate, so I won't knock Hasbro on it, but this is so ugly. I can't get behind it.
You continue to amaze me when you're out on these repaints, because I just knew this would, like, this is the crazy, strange, and unusual repaints that's usually
These GoBots, and even in the G1, you know, picture, at least this G1 picture, it looks like the orange is a little brighter, and the pink is a little more saturated, and I think that it works with that, but this dull orange and this dull pink don't do anything for me, and I really do not like this color scheme at all, because of the pink. I'd have to paint it silver or something. I think this looks horrid. And even this, I liked this, but this is still boring. There's nothing special about it. So unless Pathfinder is amazing looking, I'll probably be out on this set. And this picture is via Yestron, and these are via Transmimi on eBay. So if you want to pick it up, you could go on eBay, and I don't know how much they're selling it for, but probably way overpriced.
Yeah, I still like I still like this one. It is very boring, as you put it. There's really no colors, but I do still like it. I guess you could say I'm 33% in right now.
Well, yeah, I would be the same way. I just really don't like that Smallfoot. And here's all the GoBots that they've released so far together.
Yeah. I will probably pick up the set, but I'm hoping that I can find it on sale, of course.
Yeah, and I'm a little disappointed because you ranted and raved on that Gears mold, so I was excited to get it, and then I saw this color.
Yeah, the Gears...
It looks like a Ronald McDonald Happy Meal toy.
Yeah.
I don't know.
The pink face reminded me of Harley Quinn, like, like the with the pigtails.
But it wouldn't be pink though.
No, just the pigtails in general is the only thing. The first thing I thought of is Harley Quinn.
All right, I mean, I could see that, but that's not what I see at all. I see an abomination. Next, so TM Review showed off these pictures from, it looks like there was a prototype of the Takara Masterpiece Cliffjumper. This might not even be coming out anymore. Or it'll be under MPG. So, who knows? Either which way, I will say I like the face better than the... Oh, and that's Fans Toys Parkour. I like the face better than Fans Toys Parkour. 100%. But I like everything else about Parkour better than the Takara one, except for that sick tattoo he has on his shoulder.
T2123. I agree with you on the face, and actually probably even the whole head. And I think,
yeah,
I meant the
whole head in general.
Yeah, I think I actually like the chest better on the Takara as well. It looks a little bit like there's chest and like a midsection as well, versus it just being, you know, a red chassis. But yeah, like you, from everything else, I like better on the Fans Toys. I'm hoping we still get this. I would still pick it up.
What if it's downsized?
I would not pick it up. It's not what...
Me being a contrarian. I don't know what's going on with this. And here it is in alt mode. It looks fine. I never liked these deformed cars, personally.
Oh.
They don't make sense when everything is so, like, realistic, and then you get these things. If you saw this driving around and no clowns walked out of it, you'd be a little hard-pressed to believe that it was real.
I mean,
but it looks good with the Prime.
It's today's mini cars. Or what are they called? Not the Mini Cooper. The little two-door...
Smart cars?
Smart cars, yes. That's what it reminds me of. But I like it. It's a little penny racer. I would pick it up if it comes out.
Yeah, I know you would. It could be the worst thing in the world and you'd still pick it up.
Not true. I'm not picking up that dinobot.
Which one?
The dinobot.
No, I meant if it was a Takara Masterpiece, you'd pick it up.
Oh, okay.
If Takara came out with an MP Dinobot, you'd still... You'd pick up the KO, which I would too. which, foreshadowing, stay tuned, because there's a lot of KOs that we're going to talk about. But first, with just announced, we got Void Rivals Volume 2 Trade Paperback. It's available on Amazon for pre-order, which is pretty cool. It has a really cool cover.
It does have a cool cover. I actually just finished the recent issue yesterday.
Yeah.
It had Springer in it.
Nah, it made you happy. Stay tuned for Springer a little later, too. Next, we've got the 2-in-1 Optimus Prime masks, Optimus Prime and Bumblebee masks. I have to say, I'm getting really sick of Hasbro using molds from the previous property and just shoving it into the new... You know, movies. This looks nothing like the Bumblebee in the trailer, at least. This is from Rise of the Beasts, and they just repackaged it. And they did it with Earthspark, they did it with Rise of the Beasts, and I get it, but I'm like, just don't release it.
They're like, hey, it didn't sell. Let's put it in a new package and see if it sells now.
Exactly.
Yeah. Next.
But the Optimus Prime is new.
It looks better.
It looks better than the last one, I will agree, but you know, it's not my favorite. It's kind of cool how they gave him smokestacks still that are like the little ear things Prime has. I think that's kind of cool.
But it looks more like Ultra Magnus in the bot mode, like the colors, you know. So
I mean, what else could they really do though?
Yeah, I mean, I get
in terms of Prime's head.
Yeah, it's.
It looks better though.
Yeah.
Next, we've got the YOLO Parks AMK Mini House of Magnus Delta Magnus versus Sunstorm 2-pack. There are 14 points of articulation. There are 10 to 12 centimeters. And this was the part that got me. They will be exclusive in the U.S. to BotCon 2024. But the best part of them is this packaging.
Yeah. They look good. I won't be picking them up. I'm not going to be at BotCon either. Unfortunately,
if you were a BotCon, would you pick them up?
No.
Me too.
But I do like them. I do too.
I think they look good. Yeah.
Yeah, they look good. I like the colors. And yeah, they're cool. It's good to see more options for people who collect these.
Yeah, definitely. Next, we've got eHobbies exclusive super deformed Transformer cards, Wave 11. So they got a lot of them. And we've got Stepper and Artfire, Cheetor and Waspinator, which I put pictures of. They also had the Fallen, made from the Titanium series Fallen, Power of the Primes Optimal Optimus, and Star Saber and Victory Leo. These are really cool, but it would be better if they were packaged with figures.
Yeah, that'd be the only way I'd pick them up.
Me too.
And even then, I probably would.
Well, no, I mean, I would want, if I didn't want the figure, I wouldn't pick up the thing, but.
Yeah. I've picked up a couple of super deformed, so that's what I'm.
Oh, if it was like a super deformed, like.
Character.
Oh, I was thinking they could just come with a normal generations figure and just be like a cartooning style.
Oh.
Yeah. That's where my mind went. Anyways, we've got Collector's Craft and Funbee Studios Autobot Shuttle Bridge Terminal.
This looks really good, first off.
It does.
It looks very good. It actually makes me want to go deeper into these dead 86 characters. With, you know, I mean, you can literally sit up. This setup as a display would look amazing.
I mean, you're going into them anyways.
True.
You're getting all of them that come out.
True, but I mean, I'm waiting on them to go on clearance. This would probably make me feel a little bit more proactive to jump in even sooner.
Like if they included one piece with each set or something like that?
Not even so much, not even that. I mean, that would be dope. I'd be all the way in for that. But I was more so saying, just in general, like, if I got my hands on this, I'd probably be eager to go out and get the figures to set up with this.
Got it.
Instead of saying, okay, I'm going to wait. Instead of waiting a month for them to go on clearance.
Which we know they will. Next, we've got a Ratchet's Operating Studios ROS-044 kit for YOLO Park Optimus Prime to give them a little bit more shoulders. It looks fine. I think the original looks better.
I'm with you on that. Is that all it does is just beef up the shoulders? Or does
I think it moves the smokestacks.
I saw somewhere where it looked like it gave it more articulation. I don't know if that's correct or not. What I saw is like the arms were going all the way up like this, you know.
Maybe.
Yeah. I agree with you. I like it, the way it looks better originally.
I could see what they're saying with the smokestack, so it would be nicer if like the wider part of the smokestack was more on the shoulder pad part.
Yeah.
Which I think is what they were trying to do, but I just don't like the silhouette it gives off.
Yeah, it looks like he has football pads on.
Yeah. All right, next, Funbee Studios has Cliffjumper hands. They're making them for TFCon.
That's funny.
I'd pick one up if I,
I, would
I was there. Mm-hmm, exactly.
Yes, I would definitely pick up one. And actually... you know, let me know if you're going to TFCon and we can arrange something. I want one.
I want one
for our fans out there that might be going.
They also showed off a smokestack effect for War for Cybertron Prime with a single one, and they said that maybe Armada Prime will get like a double one as well. Which, this looks good.
I don't, from this angle at least, I don't like them.
They're not my favorite.
Yeah, I've seen some better effects, but yeah, these don't woo me. And again, maybe it's the, I don't want to say it's the best they could do for this, but maybe because it's for this, and I've seen them made for MP scale that look a lot better. Shout out to New Supply. And again, from this angle, it doesn't really do anything for me.
Yeah. They're not bad, though. So next we've got MPU. I think this is a KO thrust, but it's not at the same time. Right. So we'll get into that. First, let's talk about this alt mode. I don't like that the gray isn't black or the black isn't gray. I don't like the little black part in the center being different from everything else.
Oh.
And okay. I looked on the original G1 and it looked like all one color, but I couldn't be certain with the picture. But either which way, I don't like it.
I swear I always do this and it's not on purpose. So I just happen to have my thrust out from Make Toys because I have
that color looks a lot better.
Yeah. Me. Yeah. Because I have an issue with the wings. Which
okay, just okay, show the wings.
Oh yeah. the lazy llama beans. The tips on both were gone, so I was trying to get some replacement parts, so that's why I have it out. But since you talked about it, yeah, I do like the way this looks better than the breakup of all three colors on that. I've heard rumblings that this is not necessarily a KO of Takara, but it uses some of the aspects of Takara. But the paint is supposed to be more of a matte paint, I believe. And a lot of rumblings of it being deformation space, which, if that's the case, I love their Seekers the best out of everyone who came out with Seekers. I would pick this up.
Yeah, well, let's get into the bot mode.
There we go.
And here it is. So I did a little bit of looking because I don't know a lot about these MP figures. This is not MP Thrust.
No.
It looks like MP Starscream, the second one, and they added the thrust stuff onto it. Or, like you said, deformation space. But I hate that thrust wings are on his leg.
Oh.
I hate that. Thrust always has it on his back, at least in the ones I've had. And this just looks horrid with these big things on his leg. I think, yeah, this is really bad in my opinion because of that. Like, all that kibble is ridiculous.
Yeah. I'm recency biased since I have again this out. This one is more like what you're talking about, where it's on his, excuse me, top half of his body. But I don't remember what the G1 looks like, but I would assume...
Well, the G1 figure had the wings plugged into the leg just like Starscream's did, and they just went on.
Yeah, that's what I mean. So
it could be either which way. Honestly, I think they just have this mold for Dirge, Ramjet, and Thrust, and they didn't want to make a third one or another one for Thrust, so they just threw everything on the legs.
Yeah, that sounds about right. Depending on the price, I'll probably pick this up.
Yeah, Thrust is my favorite of the Coneheads, but I will be skipping this. I have, who was it? I got it before Zeta Toys got them. There was another company.
Toy World?
Toy World. I have the Toy World Thrust, and that's good enough for me.
And those are big. I have those too. They're big.
They are big. Yeah, that's why I like them, the Coneheads. I like the Coneheads being bigger bruisers. So. Let's move on to another KO, and we have a KO of the Transformers Bumblebee Megatron.
Wow. It looks like Destro.
Yeah. So I am interested in this because I was interested in the original one, but I'm not paying leader class price. So if this is $20, I'll pick it up. But that'll be the maximum that I would pay for this.
I don't remember how I felt about the original.
Actually, you said it looked good for what it was, but
I don't like the way this looks. And if this looks like the original, then I don't like what the original looks like. It's good having a short-term memory. Yeah, this looks like there's something missing. Like, he looks like he's missing part of his chest or part of his front, like something.
I think it's the Decepticon symbol.
Even that, I mean, it's just like this random blackness on his chest and or on his just the whole front side of his body. It just looks like it's missing more details and more colors. But if that's what the original looks like, then
I don't remember.
Yeah, I don't remember. But I'm out on
that. I just want to see how it transforms. I think it looks kind of cool. But again, $15-$20 and you'll have my money. Anything more, if it's $20.01, I'm not getting it. I'm not that interested. And even $20, ooh, that's still a lot of money for this. So let's keep it going with the KOs. And there is a KO of the New Age Omega Supreme. And there is a video that shows the differences between them. And this one is very floppy. Again, I don't know if it's a prototype, but not prototype, who knows? I'll put the video in the description if you want to see it. But yeah, that's pretty cool. Are you going to get more of them?
No.
Why not? What if they come out with some weird color schemes you don't have? Like, I don't know. A yellow one or a pink one or something like that.
So the New Age is the one that actually got me into getting all the Legends Omega Supremes that I got. But that floppiness is terrible, because even I would get the Pangu ones first if I wanted other colors, because they're cheaper, and even though they don't have all the ratchets, I think they hold up a little bit better than this one does. So
yeah,
that would be the option I would go with.
Yeah, I mean, it's fine if they come out with a black one, and again, it's like $20, I'll pick it up.
Yeah,
$20 is a good price point for all these KOs. Again, another one for $20 I'd probably pick up. We got a KO of the Ultimate Class Rise of the Beasts Primal. It looks fine, but I wouldn't be jumping for joy if I got the KO or the original.
Yeah, I'm with you on that. This looks fine. If I was more of a Beast Wars fan or anything like that.
Movie fan.
Movie fan. I'd probably be more likely to get this, but I think I have enough representation of this character, not the Primal, in my collection.
Well, even if it was a movie Prime, you wouldn't be picking it up.
You're right.
I think the swords are the best part. I like the orange deco on there. I think that's really cool. So there's a new KO people in town called Comet Shot Creations. And they're making CSC-01 Kalamori, CSC-02 Obara, and CSC-03 Yoke, and this is number 3. And they're doing MP44, MP49, and MP44S, which this one is. I think these are just Takara's pictures, but I don't know. They look fine if you need an MP44, but I think that is one of the weakest primes because of that transformation.
Yeah, it's a lot. It's a lot going on in that transformation. But yeah, if you don't already have them, a cheaper alternative, I won't knock it.
Yeah. No, and if the quality's good and the Nemesis Prime is a decent price, I wouldn't mind picking that up. And decent price, I mean like $40 to $50. So, which is within the realm of possibility with these KOs.
It is. It's possible.
Yeah. Lastly, we don't have a KO, but we have a teaser for H62 Louie, which is that like a Yeti behind him? Or is to me it looked like Eddie from Iron Maiden. But I can't get a good picture of it. So I don't know what Louis is. I'm assuming it's the shattered glass version of their slug.
I've heard everything from Willie to Scourge. Have no idea about Iron Maiden.
Is that what it is? Is that what people are saying?
Mm-hmm.
That's what it looks like. Okay. It's so dark that it could go either which way. I'm not a big Iron Maiden listener either. So.
Yeah, and I heard like one of the song lyrics or something like that, I guess.
666 number of the beast?
I have no idea. No, I didn't hear that one.
Sacrifice is going on tonight. I know that song.
Yeah.
Mm. Run to the Hills?
Yeah, no. Gets no play in my car or on my Alexa.
Not mine either. not mine. It's not heavy enough for me.
But yeah, so I've heard Scourge and I've heard Wheelie as who it could potentially be. And I also have seen a lot of comments of Legends collectors really excited about just another figure coming out from New Age. So I guess we'll have to wait and see on this. Because they have been coming out with mini bots lately as well.
Watch, they're going to do a Fans Hobby and it's going to be like an Eddie figure. And it's not even going to be Transformers related, like what Fans Hobby did with the G.I. Joe thing.
Oh, that would be terrible for the fans. I don't even know who Eddie is. I'm thinking of Eddie Monster, but...
Close enough. Let's talk about some updates. And the first thing is Earthrise Deluxe Prowl. This thing looked great. But I think it's confirmation that Earthrise is canceled because this figure is canceled. I think this is the best figure to come out of this whole... Was it Earthrise? Earthspark?
Earthspark.
Earthspark line. I think it was on a Hobby Link Japan for like $20. I was like, I might get this because it looks so nice. And it's a different Prowl. And they canceled it.
I saw this as well. And what was funny about it, I saw it and I was just like, you know what? I'm going to surprise James and get this.
I was thinking the same thing. Bobby's not going to think I'm going to get an Earthspark figure. I think I'm going to pick this one up.
I'm going to pick it up. And then I was reading this like canceled. I was like, wait a minute. I was like, Hasbro's literally saving me some money now.
Well, it's Takara, but yes. And it's funny because Hasbro's version is just a Hot Rod repaint, which doesn't make any sense for Prowl.
Yeah, this looked good. I was literally going to grab this. So, that sucks.
Yeah, me too. We also got Flame Toys Kurakarakuri Starscream. So this is going to be a little bit more than 8 inches available, and it comes with a lot of parts. So if you look, you got like the G1 styled Starscream, even though like it goes above his head for whatever reason with the wings. But he also gets like Cybertron-esque weapons, which I think is a really cool little thing.
I don't know if those are supposed to be swords, like...
I think so, because you remember the Cybertron Starscream has the swords that flip out? So I think that's what they're supposed to be.
They look amazing. Mm-hmm. Not for me, but this looks really cool. It's very stylized. I think I like him better without all the stuff on him, but... I could also see having him with all the stuff on him because he does look very menacing.
Yeah. If this transformed, I'd be picking it up. No questions asked. And maybe they will do it. They did the Hot Rod. Looks really cool.
Yeah. I'm curious to what it would look like once it did. And it would probably then, I don't know, maybe I'll eventually have like a stylized Transformer shelf or something like that.
You already probably could have a few of those with the Kang toys. But what I really wanted to talk about was how cool this cape was.
I do like the cape.
It looks really good.
It does. And I love the big Decepticon symbol on there. Mm-hmm. It looks like there's a little bit more detail in the cape than what we've seen in other capes. Because it's just basically a cloth that they throw on. And yeah. So this one looks like a true coronation Starscream. So, yeah, this looks good.
Yeah, I agree. All right, let's go through these next ones. kind of fast because we've already seen a lot of them. First thing is we have more images of Bumblebee movie Skywarp via Notrab. I really like what they did with the wings. That blue and purple and gray look really cool together, but it doesn't look like Skywarp.
The purple is really growing on me. I really like this shade of purple.
I do too. They should have called this like Hotlink or something, not Skywarp. Yeah. And then I would have been perfectly fine with it.
Yeah. I'm not picking this up, but yeah, it does look good.
You'll be picking this up.
Yeah, I'm in on this.
And this is via Toys R Us on YouTube. And we've got the Studio Series 86 Bumblebee. It looks fine. It doesn't do anything that makes me want it, and it doesn't do anything that makes me not want to get it. I'm just not a big Bumblebee fan in general.
Makes perfect sense. Mm. Like, this is for all of us 86 collectors or fans or whatever. This is like one of those where I don't love it, I don't hate it, similar to what you said, but I gotta have it.
And they had this picture, which showed him off with the other ones, and he's not as small as I thought. So, you know, I thought he was going to be much smaller, honestly, than the Bumblebee we got previously.
Yeah, I'm happy with it, and it is the one in the middle for those that don't know.
Yeah.
I'm going to be happy when I pick it up. This one will actually probably be in bot mode for me.
Next, we've got Steeljaw with how small he is. And that tape mode is so sad that they didn't even paint the other spool, I guess it's called. And I did look. The other side looks just as mismatched. What are your thoughts on this?
From this view, the lion mode looks better.
I never thought the lion mode looked horrible. It just looked like... It looked dated.
Yes. It looked cheap. It looked very cheap. It looked very thrown together. It looked like something I would put together with Play-Doh.
Well, like the wings are parts forming, I think. You have to take that whole wing and tail section off. And then it's just the guns on it.
Mm, that's
like, because you know how they showed they put the blaster speaker or whatever it is on him? I think that whole part just comes off and it's parts forming. Because if you look at the... tape, you only see the guns.
Unless they fold on the backside? I don't know. Yeah,
I don't maybe. Think so.
Yeah, that sucks too. Unless it slides down. I don't know. I'm still picking this up. Clearly, again, it's just something that has 86 on it, so I'm getting it. Similar to when I got Spike and Daniel.
Now, this is something you wanted to talk about a few weeks ago. We've got, you wanted to discuss the difference between Steeljaw and the other yellow cat, Beast Machines Cheetor.
This was not the one I was talking about, because this one actually looks good. I was talking about the other Core Class one.
This is the Core Class Cheetor.
The one that just came out?
Yes. This one looks good. These are the promotional shots, so who knows if they're photoshopped or whatnot. But this is what they put when you're going to pick it up online.
I'm not picking it up, but this isn't the one I remember seeing like that we talked about a couple weeks ago.
This is the same one.
Oh, wow. Okay. It looks a lot better.
It's funny what a little bit of lighting and making sure the paint all looks good can do.
Yeah, this looks completely different. I don't remember it looking... this good. Not good enough to pick it up.
Oh, God. He's picking up a Beast Machines character.
Definitely
not. If you put it with your MPs, it's technically scaled appropriate.
I'm so not going to do that. Yeah.
But what do you want to say about these two?
Well, nothing now, because this Beast Machines one looks a lot better than what I remember us talking about a couple weeks ago.
So what he was going to say is how the fandom got all over the Cheetor, but they didn't with the Steeljaw. But in my opinion... people are just picking up the Steeljaw because it goes with another character they like.
Yeah, it's definitely only because it's going with Blaster. And I can say that myself. This is not something I got completely excited about. what would have really made me mad is if they were like, yeah, it's $19 or something like that, or, you know,
it's getting up there. What, $11.99, $12.99?
Yeah, $11.99.
I mean, half of the plastic that goes to this is a non-transforming speaker piece.
And literally, that's gonna, you know, and another one will come with ram horn, so Blaster can have his two speakers, and yeah, but there's just no details in the feet and the legs or anything. It looks like a lion head put on a table, like a wooden table. They painted it yellow. That's all it is.
Kind of does look like that. And something that's weird to me is the gold on the guns are a different gold from the gold on the speaker. And that was a lot of gold in that sentence, but you understand what I'm saying.
Yeah. And honestly, it makes sense because this isn't for him. It's for Blaster.
True.
We all know that.
All right. Well, let's look at Springer. And these pictures are via Jeff 10. And it's a comparison with the original one. I think the original one looks so much better with those saturated colors. And I hate that glow-in-the-dark green color that they used on the thighs and the hands. I don't understand it. And if it doesn't glow in the dark, I don't know what they're thinking.
Yeah, I think I like the new one better. I like the head better. I like that the shoulders kind of tilt.
The head is like slightly different.
Yeah, the colors of the head.
Oh, you're talking about the color. Okay.
The colors, and I actually like the split pea green. I actually like the colors more on this than, because again, it's, to me, it looks more like the movie, which it's supposed to. And I'm okay with it.
Okay is fine, you're content with it.
Yeah, I like the details too, like the around the belt buckle area, you know, just how there's a little bit more detail in the yellow that's around there. It actually, you know, it's just it looks like they did a little bit more fine tuning on this. Even around his head, the little yellow pieces, it's just hollow on the original, and it looks like it's kind of filled in on the others. You know, again, it's very, very subtle. I shouldn't even say subtle because it's not. Because it's definitely some color differences and some moving parts that are different. But I like the details that they did on this more so than the
previous. Now, is it worth leader class price point? So we had a comment saying the original one came out for $25. Now this new one is $55.
When it came out,
you know.
I mean, granted, they've added...
There is a lot. So let's talk about all the accessories. So that is quite a bit of plastic.
But is all of it needed? Not necessarily.
They literally just threw those things in to make it a leader class.
Right.
And I think this needed a whole new mold if they wanted it to be accurate, because it does not look like this picture at all. And these pictures are via Oye Benin E. I think that's how you say it. The chest is in the wrong spot. The shoulder pads are way too big. Like, they needed to redo this thing from scratch if they wanted it to be a screen-accurate Springer. It's a decent Springer, but I don't think it should qualify to be in the 86 line, honestly. With how different these are and how close the Bumblebee and the Jazz and all that were, this is a very far cry from what it's supposed to look like. And then the glow-in-the-dark green... shouldn't be so green. It shouldn't be as blue as they have it here. I think it should have just been silver, honestly.
Yeah, there's definitely some holes in it and the character. I would have liked to have seen a fresh mold on this in particular. At the price point, it's somewhat disappointing. It's disappointing because, again, it's not what I thought we were going to get. I was pretty excited when they announced it. But then at the same time, I was a little kind of, maybe it won't be so great. I'm hoping it's great, but.
Yeah, you were optimistic and I was sitting here over here saying it's going to be the same thing.
Yeah. So.
And we're kind of in the middle.
I was going to say we're kind of both right. We're both wrong, you know. Yeah, there's some things I like, you know, but Yeah.
God, this is such a pass for me. It's not even funny. This is also a pass for me. We got the Voyager Vector Prime inbox images. Not much to see here, except for the artwork of that shuttle makes it look so cool.
It does. And I don't know why, but every time I see this figure, the colors change. So I can't remember if I pre-ordered it or not. But if I see it in stores, maybe I'll pick it up. Target just had a great sale this weekend I heard about and I missed it. I don't know if it's still going on, but they had the 30% off again this weekend on new Transformers. So hopefully I can find this in store and they're having another one of those sales.
Yeah, well, hopefully you can and let me know how it is because I'll be skipping on this as well. I'll also be skipping out on this. This is the Nucleos, and this is via Pokemon's Doom of TFW 2005. And there's the whole rock group together, and they look fine. They look like a cohesive unit, which I can appreciate.
So maybe it's the lighting or...
It's the lighting that makes... You mentioned it looked blue. It's the lighting.
Yeah, because I was just
like, all of them like look darker than they should have.
Yeah, he actually looks like he's in a band. The head looks like, you know, one of those bands in the 80s that, like, you know, may have wore head costumes or something like that.
And these pictures of the Anotrab, it looks fine. It looks really heavily painted, and it looks... To me, I'm like, they put all their budget into this figure. With all the paint, all the remolding, all that. It's, you know, I feel like they put money into this figure instead of putting it into other figures. But it looks good. This actually does look good. Am I going to pick it up? No. But I do think this looks good.
I like the yellow, or gold, whatever, around, which seems like it might be headlights. I didn't notice that before, or the grill in yellow. That looks good. It looks like it's some detail there. And the gold along the side of the wheels, I do like that aspect of it. But other than that, I'm not really a fan.
Yeah, I think it looks good for what it is. Notrap also has pictures of Cybertron Hotshot, and this picture where it's a little, you know, it's lengthwise, shows off why I hate these arms. The elbow's in the wrong spot. Like, it's like they considered the shoulder pads and then had the arm growing off of that instead of considering the shoulder pad where, like, the shoulder actually would be.
You know what? It does look... He's bending right here.
Yeah. Like, they should have had a way to where the red part could, like, collapse in to the shoulder or something. And then he would have normal proportioned arms.
Yeah. And then it's funny, if you did give them articulation up at the where the red and the blue meets where the tire is, then his bended elbow wouldn't bend like this. It would bend like this.
Yeah. Yeah.
That would look terrible. It still looks good for what it is. I still think I might be picking it up. I like the colors a lot on this. This camera, the pictures look really good and really detailed. And so I still may be picking this up. I don't think I would be paying that much attention to the arms personally. So I think I still might be in on this.
I don't blame you. I think it looks good. It's very accurate to the original one that came out, to its detriment.
Okay.
Yeah. So let's go on the third party side. So Fans Hobby showed off the Saber team. They look fine. It's not exciting really to me, but they look good. What are your thoughts?
I think they look good. I really do. I think they look good. I like the detail of the paint and on the windows of the jets and things. The one on the far left with the swirly kind of like pattern on it, I don't know why I look at it like it's like purse material or something like that.
You mean with the lines?
Yeah, with the lines that kind of go down and then go across, and then around the middle, it's kind of, you know, it reminds me of...
looks like a purse to you?
Yeah, it looks like a purse that...
I think that one's name is Sonar, and I think that one's always been my favorite. Because I really liked its bot mode, but they look good. They don't excite me.
They do look good, and Sonar is in the middle, and if that's his name,
I believe that's his name. Correct me in the comments if I'm wrong.
He does look the best in bot mode to me.
Yeah, I just wish he had better shoulders because it looks like he's very limited compared to the other two.
Yeah, you know, I didn't. I think that these are going to be fun to play with. You know, compared to some of the other mini-cons, like some of the other mini-cons that they've come out with have been boring, to be nice. These look like there's a little bit more to them, so I'm interested to see what these are like.
And I think the price on domestic sites is a little bit more than $30, so go pick them up at the Chosen Prime. And that's a very perfect price for these, honestly. A little bit more than $10 a figure. Hasbro would be charging more.
Hasbro wouldn't come out with them.
Well, yeah, and there's way too many parts in here for a core class figure for them.
Yeah.
They wouldn't have, like, elbows or knees.
Yeah.
But anyways, I think these look good for what they are. Next, we've got Iron Factory Leo Kaiser. So let's step into the Legends ring. What are your thoughts on this? Because I know you're picking this up.
Yeah, I'm waiting. You know, we got the first two really fast with the legs, and it's been quiet ever since. I know we saw, you know, kind of hints at all the other figures, but nothing's dropped in a few months now. So I'm waiting.
They just wanted to snag you before you forgot.
They did.
I think this looks good. I just think that, was it Hellbat? I think that's its name.
The blue one?
The blue one looks way too bright. I feel like it needs to be a darker blue.
I don't remember.
He's a darker blue.
Okay.
Maybe this is the prototype. I don't know. But I feel like that needs to be darker.
Yeah, I don't remember. I haven't looked
at him. You don't even care. You don't even know any of these guys' names.
What's your point? Drillhorn, I think, or something like that.
Yes.
Yeah, there we go.
So sad. Anyways, I think this looks anime. Good. I really like the staff that he comes with. So I think
the
mace staff instead of the spear, I think it's really a really neat design.
Yeah, it looks good. And this was one that when it was initially announced, I was like, who cares? And then I started looking at it, I was like, this looks so much better than the
TFC one,
you know, just update it for anything that I have. And so like, let me go ahead and try this out.
I agree with you. I'm looking at my TFC one. It doesn't look bad, but it doesn't look like this. Iron Factory also showed off their City Commander final battle armor, and this is via Linhide on Weibo, and it looks fine. I really like the knuckle dusters he has. I think every Magnus should have that from here on out.
Knuckle dusters?
Mm-hmm.
I've never heard it.
You've never heard of that? Brass knuckles.
I have heard of brass knuckles. I've never heard of knuckle dusters.
Don't worry about it. But anyways, he looks like he could do some damage. I think he looks cool.
He does.
Even if it was MP, I probably wouldn't pick it up because he's too wide.
This looks like, and like we joked about Hasbro and Ultra Magnus and call him Hulk Magnus and everything. This actually looks like, you know, the Hulk Buster or something like this. It's growing on me. These two pictures here look really, really good.
Mm-hmm. And I think it looks better than Hasbro's because it looks like it's intentional. Hasbro's looked like they did it because they had nowhere else to transform it and they weren't going to spend more money to engineer it better.
Yeah.
This actually looks intentional with the design they're going with.
Yeah, like everything is bulky. Like
Mm-hmm.
He looks like a a bulky, kick-ass character.
Yeah, I agree. I think it looks great.
Yeah, I'm not picking it up.
Cut now?
No.
Why not? Just get it. You have no reason not to.
I mean, you can buy it from me, and I'll have it. I'll be happy to display it.
Okay, let's do this again. You buy it to me, and then I'll send it back to you, and we'll go from there. And that's where we're ending that before we're here all night. And we've got Magic Square's Brontosaurus via June King.
It looks cheap.
The yellow, something's wrong with this yellow, and we'll get to that in a little bit. But I wanted to talk about how cool the articulation actually looks. That was great. Yeah, but it does look cheap, and especially when you put it next to this Grimlock that I think just came out.
Yeah.
Like, that Grimlock looks like a prototype.
They look like this, what, Super 7 or whatever those...
Yeah, Super 7, yeah.
Yeah, that's what they look like. They look like if Super 7 could transform.
Which is a good thing, because it's very accurate, but at the same time, that yellow on both of these figures just looks really cheap.
Yeah, and the red on his chest doesn't, like, it looks like it's still a prototype. The red and the yellow still looks like it's prototype materials, and they haven't finished it yet.
Yeah. Which is a shame, because I think there was some really cool stuff going on.
But it looks good. Like the shapes and the way it comes together looks good. I just don't really like the color of it.
Yeah, I agree. Let's talk about what's incoming. And the first one is something that you'll eventually pick up, but you're not going to pick it up right away. You're going to tell me you're not going to pick it up. And that's the DB01, which is Black Mamba Dinosaur Warrior. And then they Mang Motion had it with the TransArt version, and this just solidifies my, you know, choice to get TransArts. I think it looks a lot better, proportionality wise. And on top of that, there were a lot of issues with this dinosaur warrior. People were getting it with, so the chrome was all chipped off, the pins were in the wrong way, the head was exploded in the package. I don't know if you saw that link that I sent you. So if you have that one pre-ordered, I would recommend canceling it and waiting for the second shipment, because the company did say that they're going to be doing better. But yeah, TransArt, I think, wins in this battle here.
Ironically, they look very similar. And maybe that's because I don't like the character, so it's blending together for me. But they look very close. If I just looked at, you know, I wouldn't be able to tell which one is which.
Yeah, I agree. They do look really close. And the proportion difference between the two is a lot, but it's not a lot at the same time.
Yeah.
Like, the chest is bigger on the other one, the waist is smaller, and you could see it, but they are very close, which is good, because they're both very screen accurate, kind of. You know how those old cartoons were.
Right.
So.
Yeah. Yeah. I will be happy for you when you get it, and maybe you can show it to me and others and change our mind on it, but I have absolutely, like, I didn't like the character in the cartoon when I first saw it, and I just thought this was dumb. And now that I see the toy, I'm like, okay, it looks like who I thought was dumb on the cartoon, and I won't be picking this up.
Yeah, that makes sense. I did want to show off this picture. So this is all TransArt, so it's not the dinosaur one, which the TransArt one should be an update, but whatever. It's huge. So...
It is.
I'll be happy that it's that big, but this is a very cool picture. They all look good except for Quickstrike with that gimp arm.
So, I just, looking at this picture, how many of these do you have?
Two.
Okay.
I only have the Megatron and the Tarantulas. I have the repaint of RC. I have Ravage, which is a repaint, remold of Cheetor. I have the two repaints of Rattrap, and then I have Ravage again, which is the repaint of the Transmetal 2 Cheetor. I'm waiting on an Ape Link from that Prime, and then I'll have the Dinobot.
Yeah, I think from, if we count repaints and everything, I think I have 7 of the TransArt figures. So
I think 2, 3, 4, 5. I have 5.
Yeah.
6. I have 6. Yeah.
Yeah. They're it's about
they're great price, and you get a great figure for it, honestly.
Yeah.
In my opinion, they're one of the best price to figure ratios that you can get. Honestly, because that Tarantulas was only what, $70? So
yeah.
And it's better quality than some of the expensive masterpiece stuff you can get with third party.
Or I would agree. I really like the colors and the materials they use on the plastic that they use. It really pops, and so I agree.
Yeah, that's why you're gonna pick up the Dinobot. But let's get into what's recently released. Let's go through these kind of fast. First thing is the Optimus Prime in hand images, and this is via Nova 01, I believe. And then the other one is via Chuck CGJC. First of all, let's talk about the price to size ratio. This is crazy that the big one is cheaper than the small one. But on top of that, that face looks busted. I get it's small, but for $80, I would need it to be perfect.
My friend actually picked up one, and I'm gonna see if I can borrow it to review it.
That would be great, yeah.
Because I did not pick this up, so do not be looking for this in my haul, coming up this weekend. I did not pick this up, but I have to be honest, I kind of regret not picking it up.
Well, yeah, because you like spending money. I've heard people say that the faceplate was like misprinted on theirs, and it's floppy and stuff. So we'll see. That's all hearsay though. So let us know if you pick this up and what you think about it.
Yeah.
Next, we've got the Kindergarten Series Alicia 1. This whole set came out. I don't know when. It might have came out before, but I haven't seen anything until now. This does look really cool, but you know, definitely not for my collection at all.
Not for my collection, but this Alita one is so adorable. It is so, so adorable. And this would be something that would be like in a scary movie where it's just like the toy that comes and kills you because it's so freaking adorable.
Well, yeah, Alicia one is killing people, so. Next, we've got O1 Studio Overmind via Love on Baidu. I did look up the promo shots because it weirded me out. The wings in the promo shots are black, not see-through orange. So take that as you will, but what do you think of this?
I saw this and I was like, this looks really, really good. It is so menacing. Like, very, very menacing. Even the red eyes, I didn't think it came with the transparent orange wings as well.
Yeah, the picture though, I checked the prototype, the promo shots or whatever, had gray black wings. They were not see-through orange, because we would have talked about that if they were.
Yeah, and if it does come, I'm happy with it either way, but this looks very menacing and I can't wait to get mine.
Yeah, it needs more green. Dr. Wu's Extreme Warfare also came out, and these are via Weibo user, the Shatterglass versions, and they look good.
I saw the blaster looks really good. I mean, they both look really good, but the blaster for some reason looks really good to me.
And they both look fine. Nothing special for me. Are you going to pick them up?
No.
Good, because they're sold out in a lot of places. Lastly, we've got Touch Toys Hellbird, which I think we already talked about it being released, but what I wanted to talk about are these weapons that it comes with. This is so cool. And these are even cooler.
Yeah. I'm loving this. When I glimpsed at the picture on the left, and I was just like, is this what he transforms into? Because I was just like browsing through. And then I had to look. I was like, oh, he's actually like pounding something. I was like, okay, let's get to it. It does look cool. And the weapons are serious. He means business.
Yeah. And I think the price went down.
It did.
Right? Okay. Because I did see it. I think when we first saw it, it was like 180. And then overseas retailers have it for like 140 now, which is a much more palatable price for this. Don't think I'm going to get it still, but that is a much better price.
Yes. I will let you know how it is.
Yeah, I know you will, because you already probably have it. Well, that's everything we have for you today. There was a lot, so let us know. What was your favorite thing we talked about? And if you got this far in the video, we really appreciate you watching. And Bobby's going to tell you what you should do.
Well, first thing you should do is like the video. If you're not a subscriber already, please go ahead and click that subscribe button. It really does help the channel out. We're on our way to 1750. And at 1750, we're going to go ahead and show our collections. I know a lot of people have been asking for that. Also, click that notification button so you can be updated to when we release new material. New things are happening all the time. Also, this weekend, we will have our hauls for May. So looking forward to doing that. Please share and comment. Definitely hit us up in the comments. Love to have those debates with you guys. And I think that is all.
And if you missed anything else, you know what to do. We'll see you guys next time.
As always, to all debates are won.